Hi, this is Jan with IQRF, and the purpose of this tutorial is to explain the software architecture of the IQRF transceiver in more detail. You will learn more about versions of the IQRF operating system, DPA plugins and network types, custom DPA handlers, and you will set the basic configuration. We will show how to create nodes and the coordinator. When you order the IQRF transceiver from the manufacturer, you will get the current version of the operating system or request operating system. You can detect the version by pressing Ctrl plus M or using the appropriate menu in the IQRF IDE. You can learn more about the current version of the IQRF operating system on the website iqrf.org. There is also an IQRF OS history available. Nodes operating in SDDRF mode are usually devices powered from the mains, like power sockets, IQRF repeaters, or some sensors. Nodes operating in LPRF mode are usually devices powered from batteries, like sensors, working in power-saving mode. When creating a new network, decide which network type, STD or STD plus LP, you need. In the STD network, only nodes operating in SDDRF mode are allowed. If you don't plan to add new LP devices, you can set the coordinator for STD network. In the STD plus LP network, either nodes operating in SDDRF mode as well as nodes operating in LPRF power saving mode are allowed. If you want to mix devices operating both STD and LPRF modes in one network, you need to set up the coordinator for STD plus LP network. It is not possible to change the type of the existing network. If the changing is necessary, the network must be created from scratch. More details about network types and RF modes of devices find it in the IQRF DPA Framework Technical Guide, especially in the chapter RF Devices and Networks. In the startup package, you will find DPA plugins for coordinator and node. For a coordinator, you will usually use the SPI type of DPA plugin. No worry about the STD or STD plus LP type of the network when you look for the appropriate DPA plugin for a coordinator. Type of the network will be selected later in a configuration. For a node, you can choose the LP or STD type of the DPA plugin. You will usually use the LPE type for devices running on a battery and the STD type for devices running from mains. If you need to customize the default functionality of the IQRF transceiver given by the DPA plugin, you can do it using the custom DPA handler. Custom DPA handler is an optional user-defined C language routine that can handle various events and thus implements user peripherals, handles embedded peripherals, provides peripheral virtualization, adds internal device logic, and much more. If the custom DPA handler is implemented, it must be enabled in the configuration of the IQRF transceiver in order to receive events. In the startup package, there is a template of the custom DPA handler with all necessary events which are fully commented. You can use it when you write your own custom DPA handler. For more information, read the IQRF DPA Framework Technical Guide, Chapter Custom DPA Handler. When you have changed your C file, you need to compile it. Select the C file and press the F10 or click on the Build button. After then, you have your custom DPA handler prepared for upload to the IQRF transceiver. In the configuration dialog, you can select the band, RF channel, enable or disable embedded DPA peripherals, allow using the custom DPA handler, set the network type only at the coordinator, RF output power, RF signal filter, and set the access password and user key. The content of the configuration dialog depends on the selected DPA version. Connect the CK USB programmer to the computer and insert the first IQRF transceiver into it. When creating the coordinator, set the network type in the configuration according to your network. Select the file with configuration and the appropriate DPA plugin for a coordinator and then press F5 or click the Upload button. Replace the first IQRF transceiver with the second one. When creating a node which uses custom DPA handler, check the appropriate checkbox. the network type is in the case of node unrelevant. Save the changes, select the configuration, DPA plugin for a node, the compiled custom DPA handler if needed, and then upload these files. You can add to your project existing files and then upload them into IQRF transceiver. If you need an LPDPA plugin for a node, locate it in a startup package and add it into your project. Then, you can upload it into the IQRF transceiver. Read the detailed help for more information about TR configuration and other topics. In the next video, you will learn more about creating the IQRF network. We will explain local bonding, IQRF Smart Connect, auto network, network enumeration, and backup. To learn more about the technology, you can browse the IQRF.org or watch other IQRF videos, or find already existing projects on the IQRFalliance.org. Make your products wireless. It's simple.